Hi students, this is Alex here. In this video, we are going to evaluate this integral by transforming into spherical coordinate. For transforming into spherical coordinates, we take x is equal to r sine theta into cos phi, then y is equal to r sine theta into sine phi, and z is r cos theta. Using the formula, the value of dz, dy, dx is Jacobian determinant into dr, dphi, sorry, d theta, dphi. And this value of Jacobian determinant is, after evaluating, we get r square into sine theta. So along with that, the rest of the terms dr, d theta, d phi will come. So the correct order which we are going to use here is triple integral. We have x square plus y square plus z square into dx, dy, dz. So here dx, dy, dz, which is equal to triple integral. We are going to substitute x square, y square and z square. So which is r square sine square theta cos square phi plus r square theta sine square phi plus r square cos square theta. Then whole thing into dx. But the product of dz, dy, dx we have written as r square sine theta into, we have to change this order, that is first with respect to theta, then phi, then r. But here let's write the correct order, because first we are going to take with respect to r, which will range from 0 to a, since it is a sphere. And the second integral we take with respect to theta. So here let's change all this. First we are going to take with respect to r. So this is dr, then d theta. It ranges from 0 to pi. As per the concept, then at the end we have d phi. This ranges from 0 to 2 pi. So these are the values we take as a limit when it comes to the spherical coordinate. Now we can take r square common from this, that is integral 0 to 2 pi, integral 0 to pi, integral 0 to a. When r square is common, and from the first two terms sine square theta is common, so when sine square theta is taken common, the remaining will be cos square phi plus sine square phi, which is 1. Then here we have cos square theta. So finally this is also 1, and rest of the terms into r square sin theta dr d theta and d phi is written as it is. So finally we have integral 0 to 2 pi, integral 0 to pi, integral 0 to a. This is r square and this is r square. So we have r power 4. Then sin theta dr d theta, then d phi. Now as a first part, we are going to evaluate with respect to r. It means sin theta is constant, so we keep sin theta as it is, and integration of r power 4 is r power 5 by 5, and we have from 0 to a, integral 0 to pi, integral 0 to 2 pi. And we have d theta d phi. When we substitute the upper limit, we get a power 5 by 5, which is constant that can be taken out, and we have integral 0 to 2 pi, integral 0 to pi, and only sin theta is remaining, d theta d phi. Now the second part, we are going to evaluate this with respect to theta. So that will give minus cos theta, and when we substitute the limit, it is from 0 to pi, and the rest of the terms as it is, even the outside term a power phi by phi and d phi. Now when we substitute cos phi, cos phi is minus 1, already there is a minus, so it will become plus 1. The minus of minus, it will become plus, cos 0 is 1. So totally we have 2. Then we have integral 0 to 2 pi a power phi by phi and d phi. So this 2 can be taken out. So 2 a power phi by phi, and integration of d phi is phi, and we have limit from 0 to 2 pi. When I substitute the upper limit, we get 2 a power phi by phi into 2 pi minus 0 is 2 pi. So totally this is 4 pi a power phi by phi.